AirAsia. Issue about AirAsia, high cost. Now, AirAsia founding principle is everyone can fly. But today, look like from Sabah, not everyone can fly now. And now become so expensive, and sometimes even more expensive than MAS. One example is, it was shock of my life, from Tau Au to KK, 1,000 one way. When I check MAS, only 500. You see, sometimes more expensive than MAS. So, whip out even meal and luggage. So, today the PC is to remind AirAsia CEO about the founding principle of AirAsia is to allow everyone to fly. Just want to let you know, look like not many Sabahan can fly now, even from Sarawak also. So we hope that AirAsia will review the fare, because it's so unfair that from KK, for instance, from KK, tomorrow, yesterday I checked, only 299, the earliest flight, the F40. But today already 879, double the price. And 1050 already from 439 to 1179. And the rest also 1179 until the last flight tomorrow. You see that? The last flight actually yesterday only when we check in only 369. Now everyone 369, 416, 39, all go up to 1179. Just 15, less than 12 hours. Same also 1st December and 2nd December. Yesterday price all increased by 2 or 3 times. This is AirAsia. So today we want to draw the attention of the government for that affect the local traveler from Semenanjung to Sabah, Sabah to Semenanjung. Both sides suffer because they cannot go to KK, other Sabah for holiday, too expensive. I give you an example. On the 25th, a passenger from Tau Au go to KL, 1,100 something. And then from KL to Jakarta, only 200 something. You see, going overseas is cheaper than going to Sabah, or KL to Sabah, or Sabah to KL. So this is something very unusual. So it's not fair to the local traveler. Sipadan Island, for instance, local diver is cheaper than foreign for tourists. So the government must take care of the, must protect the local traveler. Because if you want to promote good rapport between Semenanjung and Sabah, the fare must be, they must set a ceiling for low cost carrier. They must set a ceiling. Otherwise, it's unlimited. Sometimes I said, it's even more expensive than MAS. Because MAS sometimes, at the last minute, the price drop. But AirAsia, last minute will kill you. I was given an example. Last night, we had some local from Sabah going to Surabaya. Now because of the emergency of the eruption of the volcano, they have to come back. At 8 o'clock evening, only 300, about 300. But in 2 hour time, about 10 o'clock, already more about $1,000. So that means AirAsia only cater for the whoever is the rich, you'll be safe. The poor will die like this. No money means you have to wait and die. So emergency is disadvantage to the working class and the family with children who are studying. And now it's not fair, every holiday and festive season, every festive season and holidays, the parents want to bring them to Semenanjung, for instance. Now it's beyond their means already. Because too many children, you have $1,000, one family about 5%, how can they afford? So they prefer to go to Philippines or Cambodia from KK. Even go to China, sometimes it's cheaper than coming to KL. So this is something illogical. So we want MAS and AirAsia to be must be fair to local traveler because we have to promote tourism within the country. You are chasing away all these holiday makers to foreign country. That is the tendency now. I give you one more example. March also going up to 1,004 on the 30th. Yesterday is 1,004. I think today could be more because they based on the demand. But local people, the middle class and students, and though remember, Mas and Asia, a lot of Sabahan are working in Semenanjung. During Chinese holiday or Hari Raya, they are cut off. They cannot afford because it's too expensive. So there must be a ceiling for local career. We also want the Ministry of Transport to increase competition from Tawau, from KK to Tawau, Tawau to KL. Because Marine 2 at the time not flying on this area. Now because of the massive, a lot of tourists from China, from KK to Tawau, and then they normally choose AirAsia because of mass incident, 370 incident, they choose AirAsia. That puts up the price, but the local have to pay the same price. It's not fair. So as MP Kota Kinabalu, I am very concerned for Sabah, and same time also Sandakan MP are here, and also Cebu MP also here. They suffer the same. So what Kinabalu saying something, it means something, but it's not that expensive. One may more than 1,000 is quite common. And I want to tell Asia, I got a shock of my life. That's why I remember this issue. From Tawau to KK, 1,000. But check the mask, 500. You see now, become so expensive, you cannot be a low-cost carrier anymore. So hope that if you want to be a low-cost carrier, make sure that your objective is everyone can fly. I give you another example about European low-cost flyer, low-cost airline. In Europe, I checked today, from London to Copenhagen, and from London to Budapest. From London to Budapest, return ticket, £81, about $400. The distance is far longer than KKKL. So only about $400, about $400. And then Budapest, London, first one way, only £12.99. Return, 81. And also one more example for why low-cost housing, low career flight in Europe is, it lead to it mean, it's objective. Because they are really low-cost. And I give you an example is from London to Copenhagen. Adult fare, £37. And got discount some more, £7.4. From London to Copenhagen, mean about, total is £39, is about $200. The distance from London to Copenhagen is far longer than KL, KK. The cutthroat is from KK to KL more expensive. Tomorrow, from KK, is more expensive from KL to KL, to KL to KK. And this kind of very unusual. It looks like Sabah, it looks like being chop, just cut whatever they want. Itu potong leher punya airlines dah, become potong leher. So it's not fair to Sabahan. So we beg AirAsia to reconsider your fare. Make sure that there's a ceiling, let's say, low cost housing. Low cost fare must be more than 500. Who come first come, first serve. You sort off. Don't increase up to 1,000. That is no low cost fare. Yeah?
What airline is this?
That one, you look at the airline, I don't know. It's one of the low fare, I don't know what is the
number. Ryanair or which airline?
Yeah, maybe. I will check up the way. From London to
Budapest.
Okay, I will follow up with you later. Okay, next.
AirAsia running London?
No, they're not
AirAsia. I will get the airline for you later on.
Okay, the Cebu one is something to say, okay?
Okay, just want to show you the air ticket price for AirAsia. This is Kuala Lumpur to Cebu. during the Chinese New Year. Normally, many our youngsters are coming back for Chinese New Year to celebrate Chinese New Year in our hometown. But the airfare is too expensive. For AirAsia, on the 14th of February, for KL Cebu, the air price is 1,127. I think this price normally is a mass airline business class. So it's too expensive for low-cost carrier. Coming back also 1,127. So return tickets 2,000 plus already for KL Cebu. So it's too expensive for low-cost carrier. Another thing I want to show you is not only we're not criticizing AirAsia only, but we urge the government to ceiling the price for the airfare from KL Semenanjung to Sarawak. For mass airline also, I want to show you, for mass airline even more expensive. KL Cebu during the Chinese New Year, 1,771. One way. So for return is another 1,771. So return is about 3,500. You see? Only from KL Cebu, you need to pay 3,500 for air ticket. So it's far too expensive for common people to afford the air ticket. I think government should do something with the air ticket. Not only Cebu, I want to show you also from KL to Kuching, also very expensive during the Chinese New Year. KL Kuching Chinese New Year, okay, nearly 2,000 one way. So return also 4,000.
Nobody can afford to go back.
Yeah, nobody can afford. I think this is not fair for Sabahang and Sarawakians to pay such a high air ticket price. Because we don't have much alternative to travel. We only have an air route to travel. So I think it's not fair. Government should do something to ceiling the price. I think for economy class, there shouldn't be more than 600 to travel. 500 or 600. Less is better. For low cost carrier, I think no more than 500 to travel. If more than 500, you say, if say 900 to 1,000 price, this is equivalent to a business class. So for economy, it should be less than that. I think half the price. Okay?
One way.
This is for one way. Should be half.
One way.
There's no ceiling. It's up to that. That are limited also.
Yeah, for our country, only one capital city in KL. We in East Malaysia, we don't have capital city. For our parliamentarian, we have to travel every week from East Malaysia to KL to attend the parliament sitting. So it's quite expensive. Even government pay the cost, but still this is people's money. And it's still expensive. Many universities are in Semenanjung, Malaysia. Not many in Sabah and Sarawak, only one. For the public university, only one in Sabah and one in Sarawak. So most of the universities are in West Malaysia. So it's for our students, they have to travel to study. So it's not fair, I think. Government should do something on it.